Hello, this is Dr. Vstrom and you're watching Dr. Vstrom Medical.
In order to put the fuel tank back, you need to align it from either side so that the slot of the tank falls into these rubber places, let's say. The same is true for the other side. Again, you have to align the fuel tank. After you have aligned the fuel tank to these rubber edges that I showed you before, the next thing is to use the propeller to hold, again in the same way, to hold the tank a bit up, because we have to put the hoses back. We have also to connect the fuel pump coupler and the fuel feed hose. So this is where we start from. We start from the fuel pump coupler. This is the side that goes in. And you have to hear the click and it's in place. Next is the fuel feed hose. If you remember, there was a green retainer which is already pulled back. So first put the fuel feed hose where it was in the plastic joint. Push it a bit to go inside. And then holding it, just push the retainer up. When you hear the noise, the click, it's in place. So we have two hoses from this side. The fuel tank water drain hose and the fuel tank breather hose. I'm holding the fuel tank water drain hose and I have inserted a tie wrap. It's already tied up to a point. So I'm putting it in the pipe that comes out from the fuel tank. I'm pushing it well up, and now I take my already existing tie wrap that I placed, moving it up to secure, and I'm tightening the tie wrap even more to secure it. And it's done. I will now cut the remaining part from the tie wrap with a cutter, and that's it. So what remains now is the fuel tank breather hose. It's the one with the metal safety that you need this type of pliers to secure the safety. And I'm placing the hose all the way up. Now, like before, with your special pliers, you grab one side which has got two edges, and the other side that has got one, you press the pliers, the safety is freed, you can move it
up, you move it up, you let go, and that's it. And what remains now is to also use the tie wrap just for safety. So you move it up as well, then you tie it, you use a cutter to cut the extra part, and that's it. Okay, so we follow the opposite procedure. We put the bottom part of the propeller, which is this rubber part. Make sure that none of the hoses or of the cables of the fuel feed hose and so on, they don't get caught by something else. Make sure that these plastics are again open when you move down the fuel tank. Take the upper part of the propeller, insert it into the rubber opening of the bottom part of the propeller, press it, take the 12 bolt, insert it, your socket 12 size and the socket wrench. Do not completely tighten it just a bit, because you need to put the other two bolts at the other end of the fuel tank. Okay, now passing on to the two bolts on this side. As you remember, the correct way is this edge facing towards the fuel tank. Place both bolts to the openings. Now, a very important part is that you need to align also to these two holes, and for this to happen you need to push the tank a bit to the top. That's why we did not tighten the propeller. Take your socket wrench with the extension and the hex of size 5 or whatever other hex tool you have, and as I said, we did not tighten the propeller bolt, so you lift a bit up from the opposite side, and that will give you room to tighten a bit these two bolts, and then pass to the other side. Last but not least, you have to put the side plastics. As you remember, there are two plugs, or these green plugs, and these two openings. Place them in the right place. When you hear the sound, it's secured. Do the same from the other side. Done. As you can remember, there are two very strong velcros here and on this side, and it's very important before you put the side ones, this needs to go in first, and like we said, this velcro is placed on this velcro and so on, and the other one in the other side. And there are some fasteners also, which we will put later on. Place it in the approximate position, press the velcros. This goes below this.
So we're now ready to put the black plastic. As you can remember, when we were removing it, there are three plastic slots. This one, this one, and this one. And what these are used for is that this edge with the rubber part, this one and this one, they go into these slots, and you need to align them while you're putting them. At the same time, after we align them, we will put our turning signal cable. And basically that's it from this side. First you need to attach the turning signal cable, so this part from the black plastic, attach it here, It's basically a simple clip. So you just insert it and you press. And when you hear the sound, it's already there. So as you can see, I'm going to align the three edges with the three slots, like I said. The one on the top and the two on the bottom, on the radiator side. So you align and you push with your one hand, you push the upper slot, the upper edge, you push the black plastic, and with this one you push backwards after you have aligned. And you can hear that the upper part has been inserted. So after we have slided the black plastic in, the next important thing to do is to lift this plastic up, bring this from beneath, underneath, slide it here, and then put this on top, and this part slide it underneath. Don't forget to press for the Velcro. Next step is to put our screws, our Phillips screws, here and here. So now we're ready to put the side plastic, the gray one. As you remember, it has got these hooks, and there are also associating slots. So you align the hooks in the slots, like I said, from the front. You insert the plastic to these places. Pressing so that they are aligned. So after you have aligned the slots, you need to again play, create small movements and slide or pull towards yourself to the back. The next step is to put the fasteners, the back, the one on the back. If you remember, we have separated them, inserted, press the middle, in the middle, hear the noise, the clip, and it's on. Next is the one on the front, same procedure, insert it, keep it there, press in the middle, hear the noise, it's on. Now put the upper bolt on top. As you can remember, it's a hex of size 5. Use your hex tool. Next, put this bolt on the side. With your hex tool, it should have a socket or a size of 4. So the next step is to put these two bolts on the nose, in the right side. These are both a socket hex or a tool hex of size 4. So you just put them and you tighten them. So that was the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, and remember, if you like them, they will come, the videos that is. I'm happy to, can't wait to see your comments and your requests for new videos, and thanks again. Bye.